Yeah, so the Serendipity Museum, we came up with this idea because in the bachelor program, Liberal Arts and Sciences, we talk and think a lot about interdisciplinarity. And a while ago, we read an article together about serendipity. And serendipity is something that is much spoken about at the moment, especially because of, for example, like surfing online and stuff. And the idea is always that, you know, you accidentally kind of like find interesting images or interesting topics or interesting articles to research or to read. And in this article, the authors made a very interesting point, namely that in order, you have to have a lot of pre-knowledge in order to recognize something as an interesting serendipitous finding. So you need a lot of knowledge in order to be leaped out of your frame of reference. And we thought that that was a super interesting kind of tension. And as the group of liberal arts and sciences teachers and researchers, we are participating in the Transmission in Motion seminar. And this year, the theme of the seminar is about design. So it's about thinking in making and designing by doing, in a way. And this idea of designing for serendipity then came about. Like, how can we design something that helps us to kind of both encounter, have serendipitous encounters, or how can we design something that shows you how serendipity works, especially because of this weird tension that I mentioned, namely that you have to know a lot in order to recognize something as a serendipitous finding.
So actually this change into an online teaching environment, I'd say, helped in thinking of the possibilities of this virtual aspect of the museum. For me, when designing the museum, I was very much challenged to think about guiding people through our thinking process. So creating the four different colors and thinking about the exterior of the museum, thinking about how to position different artworks within the museum, and also how to add small elements to it to, on the one hand, recreate this real feeling of a museum with a fire extinguisher, for example. Looking at the exterior, what can you do outside of a museum? How can you use the walls of the museum? And also within the museum, how do you literally create places that some might find and others might not find. So to also literally think about how to create an environment, an online environment that isn't obvious, that is also allowing for wandering.
When we were first discussing the Serendipity Museum, my first reaction about what serendipity meant to me was that serendipity is a philosophy, I feel, of anti-efficiency. Because a lot of the time in our research lives and our teaching lives and across professional life, kind of in general, since the emergence of Fordism and also now in the neoliberal state, we are pushed more and more toward rationalizing and making efficient all of our time, including our creative time, our thinking time, our research time. So we're often pushed to try to make learning and research fit within a very predictable sort of timeline, that it's expected that students will be able to learn this material within this amount of time, that every student can follow the same timeline for learning. And likewise, as researchers, that we can say that, oh, well, within the next 4 weeks, I'll get a really good idea, and then I'll be able to write that into an article in the next 8 weeks, and then it will be published in the next 6 months. Whereas we all know that those are not true, that our work is much more, again, unpredictable, and that very often having a really great idea or having a breakthrough as a learner, those are not predictable moments. Those are moments often of serendipity, when you happen to encounter something that allows you to think in a new way. or as a learner when you finally have that moment where things click and make sense to you. Those aren't actually predictable. We can create, again, a situation. We can design for serendipity. We can create situations and opportunities for those things to happen. But it's not the case that these are completely rationalizable, completely efficient kind of processes. So that's what was really interesting to me about this concept of serendipity and thinking about it with regard to teaching and learning.
I have to say that I'm my favorite part is also one I was involved in building. So not to be extra proud of myself, but there's this one assignment where you have three really artistic kind of images, and the assignment you get with it is to make a story that incorporates these very different images, and I think I really like it because it's you give this framework what I was talking about, but then somebody can make a completely a story completely of their own. And so the kind of the start is maybe identical for everyone who's doing it, but the end is very different.
The most surprising thing is that it really does feel like you're walking around in a creative space. I live for art museums and I sorely miss them. I miss having access to quiet spaces where walls are transformed into forums for art and interaction. And I kind of see the art museum as my church. And I haven't been able to go to one the last year. And I love going back into this space. I helped create it, this Art Steps Museum. And I still, when I walk in, I just feel like, oh, I'm back here. And I remember how this felt. And the colors affect how, the atmosphere in the space. The plants, there's a table with water, but also just stuff that's hanging on the walls. It really does feel like a digital space that you're moving through. And I'm really surprised myself by how the things on the wall are familiar to me. And I have built up a relationship to the digital experience there. And so when I walk in, I'm like, oh yeah, there's Carl Uppel and he's throwing paint at a wall. It's like when I walked in Khomeini Museum several years ago and saw the same film on a wall there. So that was a really great, surprising, serendipitous thing that I didn't expect to take with me. And I think people will be impressed by the fact that this digital environment can give you that, can be a pretty decent replacement for the actual physical experience.